Welcome to Memphis Light, Gas, and Water's Power Up Memphis. I am Gail Jones Carson, the Director of Corporate Communications, and I'm your host for Power Up Memphis. I want to thank you for taking time to watch our show. Today, we're going to focus on two very important topics. One is paying agents, authorized and unauthorized. Our second topic is something that's been on many of our customers' minds for a while, and that is smart meters. Today, we're going to focus primarily on meter readings and your bills and how you can handle any challenges that you may have regarding your utility consumption and utility bill tied to the smart meter. Thank you for watching, and we will be right back. Welcome to Memphis Light, Gas, and Water's Power Up Memphis. I'm Gail Jones Carson, your host, and today we have Brenda Chisholm Reddick as our guest. And Brenda is the manager of payroll, cashiering, and banking. And we're going to discuss today the various ways that are available for our customers to make payments on their utility bills. Welcome, Brenda.
Thank you, Gail. Glad to be here.
Could you go into the number of ways that Memphis Light, Gas, and Water makes available to our customers to pay their bills?
Absolutely. Memphis Light, Gas, and Water offer about five or six different ways. One of the best ways is to come into one of our five convenient credit offices, and electronically they can call us over the IVR and make payments over the IVR. They can also do business on my account on our website at mlgw.com. They can also visit our authorized paying agents. There are also unauthorized paying agents out there. So those are some of the ways that they can pay the bill.
But the My Account option, which you can go to mlgw.com and select My Account,
yes,
that is one of the most convenient ways for our customers to make payments on their bill. And also when they go to My Account, there's a lot of information about their utility consumption, usage, and different energy tips and information, and all kinds of very useful information for our customers on the My Account. So lately, we've had, well, before we go into that, could you tell us where the five community offices are for our customers?
Yes.
The locations.
Yes, we have a location at 2424 Summer. I don't have all the addresses, okay, but they're on Lamar Avenue, right in the mid-heart of the city. They have one in Whitehaven on Shelby Drive and Everest Presley. Mm-hmm. And we also have our Millerton branch and downtown, okay, office on Main Street.
Okay, so those are the five locations that,
yes,
our customers have. And so when they go in, they can go in and make payments on the utility bills at our community offices. What else can they do at our community offices?
At our community offices, some customers like to maybe pay at the last minute. Well, that's the best place to pay if you're going to pay at the last minute. At the community offices, you not only can pay your bill, but you can also talk to a credit counselor to get payment arrangements on your account. In the event you need a payment arrangement, you can go on either side, the cashier side to make a payment, and also on the credit counselor side to make arrangements on your bill as well.
Okay, so when you go into our community offices and make a payment, then the payment shows immediately.
Yes.
Okay, so if customers have a cutoff notice, say they're scheduled to be cut off today, what do you recommend for those customers to avoid a cutoff that particular day?
Okay. Customers that are scheduled for a disconnect on today, mm-hmm, the best thing to do is to come into our credit office, because,
okay,
those payments are posted immediately.
Okay.
If the last minute payments, that's the best thing to do, to come into our credit offices.
Okay, so
as soon as you can before you disconnect it.
Is there a particular time they need to be there, or do they need to be there the first thing that morning, because the cutoff notice has already hit the street?
Yes.
Possibly.
Our doors open at 8:30, and we really try to get our customers to come in before the actual cutoff date, because we can't guarantee that their services won't be disconnected on the day of cutoff.
Okay.
But the sooner the better. Sometimes if they get it there in time, they can prevent a disconnect.
Okay. But just say the customer doesn't get there in time and they are disconnected. What are their options?
If the customer comes in and pays the amount of the disconnect notice, the cutoff notice, they will be reconnected the same day, especially if it's before 1 or 2 o'clock.
Okay, so the recommendation is if your services are disconnected, come in as soon as possible if you want to get them reconnected the same day. And we try to get them on the same day. However, there may be emergencies that come up that we may not Absolutely. Be able to get to the customer that day. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Okay, so there's no guarantee there's that no they'll guarantee. Be reconnected the same day, but our goal would be to get them on the same day if we can get to them.
Yes.
Okay, so that's coming into the community offices. And we've talked about My Account, which they can pay online. And then the other, one of the other options is our authorized paying agents.
Yes.
So how many payment agencies does MLGW have that are authorized? And also, could you define what a payment agent is for our viewers?
Okay. Our customers enjoy the benefits of going to our paying agents that are authorized by Memphis, like Gas and Water. I could name a few, like Kroger's, okay. Ace, Cash Express, mm-hmm. Superlow, those type paying agents. We already have a contract with the payment processor mm-hmm. that are processing those payments. And once customers go in there, and before 3 o'clock, we can post those payments within 60 minutes.
Oh, okay. So if they go to an authorized paying agency, within 60 minutes, it'll be in our system.
Yes.
Showing up in our system, so that's kind of a safeguard for them to avoid a cutoff if their cutoff is scheduled for that day. However, if they do have a cutoff scheduled for that day, they need to come to the office.
Absolutely. Come into the office if they're cut off for that day.
And so when a customer goes to an authorized MLGW paying agent, which is not an MLGW company, it's just that those are companies that we work with.
Yes.
We approve working with them. What's the criteria when they go into one of those locations to make a payment?
One of the things, Gail, that we ask our customers to take with them is their both portions of their utility bill.
Okay, when you say both portions, you mean the part that says the amount and the part that you mail in, or what? Because it's folded like three ways, right?
Three ways, right. Is there two separate parts of it? One of them gives the details of your usage and so forth, and the bottom part is what part that you mail in.
Okay.
We ask the customers to bring both portions of their bill to make sure that their money is deposited in their correct account and so forth. And that way also ensures that we can post their payments in a timely manner within that 60-minute time frame at those authorized agents.
Okay, so is there any other information that our customer needs to know about? You say there are about 100 authorized agents?
I want to say about 75.
About 75. Okay, and so if our customers go to www.mlgw.com, then they will be able to find a list of the authorized paying agents?
What we give customers is to go to MLGW agents.
MLGW agents, one word, dot
right.
com.
MLGWAGENTS.com.
Okay.
They can put in their zip code and they will receive a list of agents that's in their area. So
that makes it really convenient for them.
Absolutely.
By putting in, they put in their zip code and they can select whether they want agencies within 5 miles with
yes.
the zip code or 100 miles. So it makes it convenient for our customers.
Absolutely. That's what we're looking for, convenience for our customers.
And I'm sure that they appreciate it. I appreciate that MLGW makes that available to our customers. Also, so let's go into the unauthorized agents.
Okay. The unauthorized agents, well, first of all, the authorized agents, we have a contract with these agencies. We have a relationship with those agents. Conversely, the unauthorized agents, Memphis Light, Gas, and Water, doesn't have a relationship or contract with these agents. Although Memphis Light, Gas, and Water can't control where customers pay, we do want to get the word out that unauthorized agents, because they do not have a relationship with us, it could take 3 to 5 days to get their payments posted. Oh. As opposed to the authorized agents, which takes less than 60 minutes.
So those agents, well, the authorized and unauthorized tend to promote that they are a one-stop service where they can pay their utility bill, their phone bills, their cell bills, their cable bills. And so the ones that are unauthorized, we just don't have a relationship with them. So therefore, the payments take longer to show in our system.
Right.
So it's like some of the payments may be mailed in, or do they pay at a kiosk, or?
Right now, it's not a kiosk. Right now, it's like at Kroger's. You go to the service desk to pay your bills, mm-hmm. like that. But we do ask you to take your utility bill, whether you're paying with unauthorized or authorized mm-hmm. agents. Either one, take both portions of your utility bill. On the your question was on your unauthorized agents, mm-hmm. what else do they need to do? Mm-hmm. That's about it. But they need to know that if there are, they could be disconnected within that 3 to 5 day time frame.
So it takes longer. So customers who go to unauthorized places, they probably just don't know that this is unauthorized and that it would take longer for their payment to show up. So they can also go to MLGWAgents.com and they can find a list of unauthorized.
Not unauthorized. We provide the authorized agents.
We don't have a list of the unauthorized for our customers, just the authorized. But with the number that we have available, 75 authorized payments, plus our 5 community offices, plus being able to pay online, we have a number of convenient ways for our customers to make payments.
Yes, that's what we want
to
do.
So is there anything else that you would like to say to our customers before we close?
Yes, we just want to make sure that we're using communication channels like this to get the word out, to just give customers the information they need to make informed decisions about their payments. Okay. We do encourage, as they move closer to their disconnect date, to go into the office, but we do have the IVR and also My Account to pay online before 3 o'clock. That's still a safe way to do it before the disconnect day.
Okay.
We want customers to know if they go to authorized agents, it takes less than 60 minutes or less to post their payment, as opposed to unauthorized, it's taking 3 to 5 days. If it's not a last minute payment and you have the convenience of 10 days, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 days to pay your bill, unauthorized agents may be. We're not encouraging it because it does take a while and we have no relationship with those agencies.
Okay, thank you very much, Brenda, for sharing your information with our customers today. It was much needed, and I hope that that our customers can find what you said most useful. Is there a number that they can call if they have additional questions?
Yes, the MLGW number, the 544-6549 number is the number to call if they have additional questions. And we're sending out bill inserts with this information. We're putting information in our community offices about the list of agents that we have. We're arming all of our personnel with this information in case they have customers have questions.
Okay.
We're doing a number of things. We're mailing out letters to customers that we are known to go to an unauthorized agent just to give them additional information so they can make informed decisions.
That's wonderful. That is so wonderful. And again, we greatly appreciate you sharing this information with us.
Thank you,
Brenda.
At MLG&W, we're working hard to make your life simpler. With our new prepay option, you have the flexibility to choose when you pay your bill. Pay a little each week or once a month. You're in control. And with Prepay's simple-to-use interface, you can initiate payments, set balance alerts, and track your balance and usage in real time. Plus, with Prepay, there are no late fees, deposits, or reconnection fees. Avoid any end-of-month surprises with MLG&W's Prepay system. Come into a location and sign up today.
Welcome back to Power of Memphis. I'm Gail Jones-Carson, your host. And today, our second guest is Eliza King, and she is the Smart Meter Project Manager. Welcome, Eliza.
Thank you, Gail.
We've had, in the last few weeks, a number of our customers complaining, customers with smart meters complaining about their bills. Some of them have been underbilled, and when we have learned that they were underbilled, then we true up or work with them on the actual amount of what their true amount is. So can you explain to me why we are having this this challenge right now?
Absolutely. Before I start explaining, I want to talk about this project as a whole.
Okay, that'd be great.
This is a huge project. Memphis is what we're trying to do. Is we're trying to install 1.1 million meters.
And that's electric, gas, and water.
Electric, gas, and water meters.
And is that residential and commercial or just residential?
Residential and commercial.
Okay.
We want to put smart meters in every home, in every business. And so that means we're redoing all of our infrastructure mm-hmm. as it relates to the meters and how we get the information back from the meters. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people need to understand a smart meter is the same meter that you already have, except it has a communication component. It's that two-way communication that smart meters afford the utility.
And so what is it communicating to like gas and water? What is it, those meters, the electric, gas, and water, communicating to the company?
Well, you know, a lot of information, but certainly one of the things that it communicates is the readings. Mm-hmm. So we can get readings every day. We can get readings in hourly increments and 30-minute increments. You know, just a lot of different things, but it also alerts us when there might be a water leak. Uh-huh. It alerts us when there may be a problem that we can be more proactive with. So it gives us information, and it also gives the customers more information. They can see their usage. Rather than waiting for the end of the month to get your bill, you can see it daily. You can go online and you can see it daily. So it gives much more information. It gives the opportunity for us to share more information with our customers.
Okay, so based on you talking about the customer being able to keep up with his or her utility consumption, is that one of the reasons that is very beneficial for our prepaid customers who don't want to wait 30 days, 31 days to get their bill based on prior consumption?
Absolutely.
So with this, they pay in advance? Could you explain the prepay?
They pay in advance, and they pay as much as they want to during the month. Mm-hmm. So if you, let's just say you are a waitress, you're in college and you're a waitress, and you get tips. Mm-hmm. So you could come in and pay $10 a day if you want.
Okay.
Or you could pay $20 a week if you want, mm-hmm. because you get to see every day how much you use mm-hmm. and how much you need to pay. So that sort of pay as you go or pay as you like or whatever, rather than waiting for the end of the month and then you get this surprise at the end of the month.
So
that
this
tells
way
you how
also
much you,
you
use.
Can say, okay, well, yesterday I used so many kilowatts of this, I need to use less tomorrow because I only have X number of dollars left
exactly.
on my account.
Exactly.
And so what does a customer, in addition to a requirement being that they must have a smart meter, what else is required of customers to use this prepaid program?
That's it.
That's it?
If you come in and you have your smart meters or if you want to get on prepay, we will install your smart meters. Then you need to pay at least $100 to get started.
And so that $100 can be used toward their usage?
Absolutely. It's not a deposit. Is for whatever you use.
Okay, and it's just starting out with $100.
That's starting
out.
So
what about reconnects and disconnects and deposits?
So if you get turned off, mm-hmm. there is no reconnect fee.
Mm-hmm. And how much, for normal regular customers who are not on prepay, how much is a reconnect fee?
$25.
$25.
Yes.
Okay.
So I wanted to explain that, and I wanted to tell you, too, that we started this project in May of 2016.
2016 was the full rollout, but we also had a test in 2010. We started a test mm-hmm. of 60,000 meters.
Well, we had the pilot in 2010 of 1,000.
1,000, okay.
Only electric.
Okay.
Okay. Then in 2014, we said, okay, let's try this with electric, gas, and water.
Okay.
And that's when we did the 60,000.
Okay. And the city council gave us approval to do that.
Absolutely. And then we went back to council and said we wanted to do it all over the county.
And based on the success of the 60,000, mm-hmm. the council approved us moving forward.
Correct.
And our customers don't have to have a smart meter, correct?
They don't have to have a smart meter, but certainly I think that there are so many benefits associated with it. So this program is still, this whole project is still under construction.
And it's a major, major rollout.
It's a major rollout.
1.2 million. You've had to change the infrastructure, upgrade it and everything. So naturally, you're going to have a few little glitches.
Exactly, because you're having to reprogram everything. Mm-hmm. And right now, it's really difficult for us because you still have customers that have the old analog meters and then you have the smart meters.
And so analog meters are not made anymore, right?
They're not.
Okay.
They're not. But because we only have about 700,000 meters that we have installed, we still have to maintain that analog process until we get everything rolled out.
So right now we have 700,000 electric, gas, and water.
Right.
smart meters installed. So mm-hmm. what is the time frame that we expect to have everything rolled out?
Well, you know,
customers who want smart meters.
The project was supposed to be over by 2020.
Okay.
And honestly, we are ahead of schedule.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah, we're ahead of
schedule.
Our hope is that we will be finished with all residential customers by the end of this year.
2018?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
And then we want to be finished with all commercial customers by the end of 2019. That's our goal.
Okay.
But the project is slated for 2020.
Okay, so we will be 2 years ahead for residential customers and a year ahead for commercial customers. So we will have all that completed behind us. And so let's go back to these customers who are being underbilled because of the module
yes.
that's attached to the smart mm-hmm. meter. And the module is what is reads the information and sends it to Lygas Water. So could you explain that process to us and why there's been some underbilling?
Absolutely. Again, I want to emphasize we're under construction.
Okay.
And so I want to make a parable too.
Okay.
Because, you know, we have all these road constructions going on. Mm-hmm. You remember when they were doing the flyover that took about 2 or 3 years for mm-hmm. them to complete it. And every time I went down that expressway, I would just say, you know, this is just horrible. This is horrible. I hate coming this way. But when it was finished, it was great.
It was wonderful.
It was great. I mean, and right now they're repairing all those bridges on the expressway near Poplar. But they're doing it so that we can be safer. And so I know the end result is going to be great. Well, it's the same with us with this project. So we have electric, gas, and water meters. The electric meter, the communication component is uh-huh. built into the meter.
Uh-huh.
The gas and the water meters have a separate communication, what we call module, and they collect the reading, they send the reading to the electric meter then transmits it to us. Okay? So what happened with some of these gas meters is that module was sending erroneous readings. It was sending us zero reads. Now, it was difficult for us to catch that because a lot of our gas customers only use gas for heating purposes. So from April to November, they don't use any gas. So their consumption is normally zero.
So even if it looks like you got a back bill for 2 years, it's not a true 2 years because for 7 months, if it's for gas, for 7 months you don't have
you may
gas
not
on.
Have used any
you
gas
used
anyway.
Yeah, exactly.
And so we had some customers, and to those customers, I want to say I truly apologize because that is an inconvenience. But I just want them to hold on and stay with me and understand we're under construction and we're trying to make it better for all of our customers. We do feel that smart meters will make things better for all of our customers, but we got to get there. We've got to finish all of our programming. We've got to finish all of our installations. We're right now in the middle of change management where we have a company coming in and say, okay, this is how you used to do it and this is how smart meters can help improve that efficiency. So they're looking at those things. We've got to go back and retrain our employees so they will know what to look for as it relates to an exception. I do want to apologize for this inconvenience, but just know, like most other things that are under construction, when it's over, it'll be much better. And any time that we have an error, mm-hmm. on a customer's bill, I want our customers to know that we will work with you. We won't require you to pay it all at one time. We'll spread it out. We'll let you spread it out for as long as that error was made. And then we'll even be a little bit more lenient. We'll say, if that's uncomfortable for you, we'll try to spread it a little bit more. We want to work with our customers any way that we can.
And that is one of the very great things about Light, Gas, and Water. Many customers, some of our customers may not know that, but we bend over backwards to provide as many payment plans and options to our customers. We need customers to work with us before they get cut off, and we will have a plan for them. But now back to the module.
Mm-hmm.
When a customer is back billed,
mm-hmm.
well, one customer I talked with, he felt that Light, Gas, and Water, since it was our era, that he shouldn't have to pay. Well, legally, we are not allowed to be able to give away free services.
Absolutely.
Another man His bill was less. He noticed his bill was less than it normally was. So what he did was he took that amount of his payment that he would have paid and put it aside. So when we finally caught the error and it kicked out, he had saved up, and he just paid like gas and water because he knew that he had used the service, that he was getting heat, and he knew that he was going to have to pay it because if you use the service, you got to pay for the
service.
You got
to pay for it by law.
And law, you got to pay for the service. Like gas and water is not allowed to give away free service.
That's correct.
And we're not saying that to be mean or ugly. We're following the law. We just can't give it away.
Absolutely.
So,
And one other thing I want our customers to do for me, and that is look at your bill every month.
Every month.
Every month. We have it itemized. And so you know if you have used gas. I mean, you don't have to know a lot about gas, electric, and water. But if you know you've used some gas and you see zero for the consumption,
you're not going to get away. You got to pay it.
Yeah,
you use the gas and you see zero usage on that. That's a problem. You need to call like gas and water.
Absolutely.
Don't wait till the bill gets 2, 3, 4 months old. Call us and let us know there's
Absolutely.
A problem and try to get it caught on the front end.
Right.
And we'll work with you because, I mean, it's going to true up at some point.
It is.
At some point, we're going to know exactly how much usage that customer has used.
Right. And that's what I want them to do. Just look at it, call us. You know, we have a lot of customers call us and say, I think my bill is too high.
Exactly.
But we have very few to call us and say, look, I know I'm using gas, but I do have some.
Uh-huh.
I do have some that will call and say, I know I'm using, but it's showing zero. Can you come and check my meter? So when you look at that bill, look at it line by line, because we have everything itemized.
Exactly.
And
one point I want to make is that customers may not know is that at least 25% of their bill is not even related to electric, gas, or water uses. Those are fees that are on the bill that are not like gas and water fees. What number should our customers call, Eliza, should they have concerns about their bill, whether it's over too much usage, under usage, or any problem with their bill, period? Who should they call?
544-6549. If they think it's smart meter related, just let them know that. And that they will contact the smart meter department, mm-hmm. and we will send somebody out to check it. But anytime you have a problem with the bill, just call that 544-6549 number, mm-hmm. and they will get somebody to check everything out for you and get back with you.
Well, Eliza, I personally want to thank you for the work that you do for Memphis Light, Gas, and Water and our customers. You're one of the experts at Memphis Light, Gas, and Water on smart meter and so many other areas at Memphis Light, Gas, and Water. And I have to call on you all the time for information. And I just want you to know I greatly appreciate you. The company greatly appreciates you. And I'm sure our customers appreciate you. So thank you very much for coming on.
Thank you, Gail. I love my job. I love doing the work that I do.
I'm not letting you retire either.
And I do appreciate the opportunity to come on and explain what happened.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.